A capital crime, as you probably know, is an offense that is punishable by death. The term comes from the Latin word caput, which means head, and capital punishment originally meant literally losing your head. This controversial kind of punishment is still retained in 58 countries, while 102 countries have it but don't use it. 32 countries have abolished it altogether, with another 8 countries saving it for only special crimes. An example would be genocide. In most countries, it's saved for the most heinous of crimes, such as murder, war crimes, or crimes against humanity. But if we look at the ever-progressive Saudi Arabia, you could lose your head over there for adultery, robbery, witchcraft, homosexuality, and, according to the BBC, even repeated drug use. Though we guess even just being a journalist will do it nowadays. But if you think that's crazy, well, listen to this episode of the Infographic Show, Capital Crimes of the Past. We'll start with Europe and move on to the USA later. If we look at the UK, a place where once upon a time you could have your limbs pulled off, your internal organs ripped out, and any other manner of awful punishments happen to you, you could say things have vastly improved. The last time they had an execution in the UK was on the 13th of August 1964, and that was the hanging of two men, Gwen Evans and Peter Allen, for stealing a few quid from a man and bludgeoning him to death in the process. The Guardian writes that there was no public outcry, and the event only got a couple of lines in the British press. Nonetheless, that was that. The Labour government wanted the end of capital punishment in the UK, and it was abolished in 1965. It remained somewhat legal for certain punishments such as treason until 1998, but no one was hanged during that time frame. Believe it or not, when England introduced drop hanging in 1783, it was seen as quite humanitarian and a move forward in terms of morals. It was the same time in France when it introduced the guillotine for capital crimes in 1792. The reason for that, of course, is that it was supposed to be quick and painless, rather than long and drawn out, excuse the pun, torture that ended in death. It wasn't until then that hanging replaced burning at the stake as the punishment for treason in England, while the Scots burned their supposed witches for a while longer. This was progress, times were moving on, and the historians tell us that the English were not so frivolous in their executing. We're told that during King Henry VIII's reign, there were 10 executions every week in London. The writer Steven Pinker writes that people in those days might be executed for as little as stealing someone's cabbages. If we look at the list of UK capital punishments in England as late as 1822, the barbarity of present-day Saudi Arabia comes to mind. That year, we saw the very last hanging for shoplifting in the country. How many of you have lifted a candy bar in your lifetime? An execution for witchcraft was no more. Still, you might find yourself in the gallows after a minutes-long trial with the judge telling you that you'll be hanged by the neck until dead for what might seem like today's minor offenses. Of the 222 capital offenses, there was cutting down a tree, poaching, robbing a rabbit warren, begging if you were a soldier or sailor, damaging Westminster Bridge, pickpocketing, stealing from a shipwreck, maiming cattle on purpose, being in the company of gypsies for more than a month, strong evidence of malice in a child aged 7 to 14, being out at night with a blackened face, stealing horses or sheep, arson, forgery, fraud, letter stealing, rioting, and sacrilege. We can find only one person who was hanged for the latter from 1723 to 1820. We should add that the US National Institutes of Health tell us that across England, Wales, and Scotland, there were contrasts in how this punishment was applied. It seems by far the south and southwest of England saw the highest rate of hangings. Property offenses such as burglary ended with thousands of executions in England over a few decades, but few in Scotland and Wales. We might also add that, of course, murder was a capital offense, but that's a given. Not everyone convicted of capital offenses went to the gallows. We're told that there was a golden age of what is called the Bloody Code, and this was from 1816 to 1820. 5,583 sentences of death were handed down, and yet only 518 people were hanged. It's said that many were pardoned, while others joined the army or navy or were sent to Australia to eke out an existence there. Thankfully, from 1822 and through to the 1830s, many of these capital offenses were removed. One of the reasons for the change was the introduction of police forces, which were supposed to help reduce crime rather than the old tactic of just preventing crime by scaring people with the consequences. By 1861, there were just 4 capital offenses. They were murder, high treason, piracy with violence, and arson in the Royal Dockyards. We're not exactly sure, though, what would have happened to you then if you went out robbing rabbits from warrens with your close gypsy buddies. We might also remember, in view of what we see as absolutely heinous and despicable today, is that England in the 19th century, there was still a capital crime of committing the detestable and abominable vice of buggery with mankind or beast. Yes, that includes mere homosexuality. The last Brits hanged for this were James Pratt and John Smith. Their execution was on the 27th of November, 1835. The reforms after 1822 weren't exactly humanitarian across the board. Our American viewers must now be thinking that those Brits were a brutal lot, but those living in the New World were not always that far removed from such brutality. America had its own terrible laws. While it's hard to find exactly how many homosexuals were executed in the US, even after its independence from Great Britain and the creation of new laws, it seems the country wasn't all that progressive. One academic that wrote a paper on this says, "It appears that in 1776, male homosexuals in the original 13 colonies were universally subject to the death penalty, and that in earlier times, for a brief period in one colony, lesbians had been liable to the same punishment for relations with other women. We just can't find any instances of the death penalty being applied for homosexuality back then. We do know that Thomas Jefferson thought that he was being forward-thinking when in 1779 he tried to create a law in Virginia which meant that men convicted of sodomy would be castrated rather than executed, but his idea was rejected. Okay, on to the USA and its past capital punishments. But first of all, what are the present capital offenses, as the country hasn't given up the ghost just yet on killing people for crimes they committed? We're told that there are currently 41 such offenses, and you all know the obvious, such as murder. This list contains many instances of how such a murder can happen, such as murder at an airport or in a drive-by shooting. But you can add to that list destruction of aircraft, motor vehicles, or related facilities resulting in death. Espionage, death resulting in destruction of government property. Genocide, mailing of injurious articles with intent to kill resulting in death. Large-scale drug trafficking, treason. All of the others just about are related to the willful taking of life. Even today, many people receive the death penalty, but many of those people are not executed. We're told that since 1976, 7,800 people in the USA have been sentenced to death, and just over 1,400 people have been executed. As of April 2018, there are 2,743 people residing on death row. We should add that some states, 20 at the time of writing, have abolished the death penalty altogether. Back in colonial times, before America gained its independence, you can, of course, compare capital offenses to those of Great Britain. Historians tell us that you might be sent to the gallows in the 1600s and 1700s in the US for witchcraft, stealing food, heresy, trading with the local Indians, or when slaves killed their masters or masters' wives or family, traitorous denial of the king's rights, kidnapping, perjury in a capital trial, or striking one's mother or father upon complaint of both. Another historian tells us that you can add to that horse theft, counterfeiting, adultery, arson, bestiality, piracy, slave revolt, concealing birth, and burglary. From 1600 to 1700, the execution rate for crimes other than murder kept dropping. But even after 1776, when the US gained its independence, there were still quite a lot of people being killed for their crimes when those crimes were not murder. Not all states were the same. We're told that some states were much more lenient. But then we found a list of capital crimes in North Carolina in 1837. These included many crimes we have already listed, but also highway robbery, dueling where death occurs, castration, hiding a slave with intent to free him, bigamy, that's marrying while married, circulating seditious literature among slaves, inciting slaves to rebel, taking a free Negro out of state to sell him, and also the vague crime of causing mayhem. Some states were way more progressive, having heeded the warnings of European Enlightenment writers in the past. Things were changing, such as many social critics writing that public hangings should be ended. Like in the UK, these live executions drew in large, sometimes rowdy crowds. Then in 1846, Michigan became the first state to abolish capital punishment. Wisconsin followed a year later. There were caveats, though, such as you won't get executed as long as you don't perpetuate treason against the state. There was a kind of breakthrough in 1972 when the Supreme Court ruled that capital punishment was a cruel and unusual punishment, and for 3 years it looked like an end to such punishment. Of course, things changed. From the beginning of 2018 to December 5, 2018, a total of 22 people in the USA were executed for their crime. The last one was in Texas, and the now dead man's name was Joseph Christopher Garcia. He'd escaped from prison in the year 2000, and he was accused of going on a crime spree after the escape with six of his fellow escapees. During that spree, he was said to have killed a police officer during a robbery on Christmas Eve. He denied this, but all men except one that committed suicide were handed the death penalty. Only two were still alive and waiting execution. After hearing this, what's your take on the death penalty? Should there still be one, or should it be abolished? If not abolished, which crimes deserve to be a capital offense? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other show, Worst Punishments in the History of Mankind. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.